Did you go to your happy place?
Yeah.
Did you envision a babbling brook like I described?
I started out with the babbling brook, but then I layered in elements from our world. I'm sure fans of the babbling brook will complain, but I felt that it was limiting.
Well, it's best to keep it simple.
It was a babbling brook.
Abed, you ready for our last first day of school?
You ready, buddy?
I just need a minute.
This is my show. It's about me and all my friends.
This Happy Community College show is filmed before a live audience inside of my head.
We have to make this year count, especially since it's the last one.
I took some extra classes online, and I'm one history credit away from graduating.
Jeff, you're graduating early?
Well,
are you sure?
Yeah, I'm fine.
F-I-N-E or F-Y-N-E? We made one of them a code for not fine.
Oh. F-Y-N-E.
Okay, he's fine. Let's go.
But I think the fairest way to handle this is to have everyone repeat the last 3 years.
You can't be serious.
Indeed, I am.
We're gonna be here forever. 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 Forever.
I'm gonna stand here forever.
All these balls. I'm so close I can taste it.
After just one forensics class, I found a way to retrieve our student records. It turns out there's a backup, and it's in a safe.
Oh. Here, one more ball to go, but it's another dance contest, so I think I got it. What's wrong with Abed?
No, don't open the safe. We're redoing our first 3 years. That's what I want.
It's okay, Abed. Here's a trick I use when I feel overwhelmed. Just imagine a happy place and then go there.
Is he in his imagination emporium?
Dreamatorium? Mm-hmm. No, this seems like something new. Abed was having some anxiety about all the changes this year, so I may have told him to go to a happy place in his mind.
You told him to go somewhere? In his mind? Do you realize who you told that to?
Hey, guys.
That even if we go somewhere, we're not going anywhere.
That was a killer speech, Jeff.
I didn't say anything. I literally just walked up.
I know. I made the speech for you. It hit all the right notes. I was trying to hang on to this moment because I was so afraid of the future. But then I realized all of this was once the future. And it was completely different from what I'd known before. And it was happening so fast. But in the end, or in the now, I guess, it turned out great.
And Andre is going as Han Solo.
Aww.
The boys are stormtroopers and little baby Ben is an Ewok.
Aww.
Oh, you don't have enough children. Does Vicky have a TV?
Abed, it's a party. You're not watching TV.
We don't want to go over the same area twice, so be thorough.
Thorough, got it.
Give it here!
I remember when this show was about a community college. Are you watching Inspector Spacetime?
Why does he have to wake up so early? Can't we just tell Abed that we're sleeping together?
No. Abed's fragile. We have to ease him into it, okay? Do we want him to freak out and then we have to rescue him from some fantasy world where submarines are small enough to enter the bloodstream? I totally want to do that.
We need to go over the convention schedule again.
Troy!
I printed out several maps of the convention center and color-coded the best potential routes. Now, we know I have longer stride, but I'm assuming your superior physical fitness will allow you to compensate with greater speed. One thing's for sure, though, we need to save time by changing into our costumes in the car.
Haha, yeah.
I know you two are having sex. I've known for weeks.
What? Why didn't you say something?
I love donuts.
Who?
Wait, was there a female inspector?
Yes, and everyone hates her. Not because they're sexist, because she sucks.
Well, I think it's cool.
Great eye.
Annie! You're on your own, Al Capone.
Everyone's entitled to their own opinion.
Am I the only one freaked out by that?
What?
We wanted it to be a surprise.
You bear a striking resemblance to Inspector Spacetime supervillain, Thoraxis.
Who's Toby?
Toby Weeks, arguably the biggest Inspector Spacetime fan in the world. We've been emailing for months.
Oh, you never mentioned him.
Well, you've been so busy lately having sex. Besides, we talked about embracing change, so I'm expanding my social circle.
Someone might just happen to have a pair of tickets to the sold-out panel.
Toby, did you see
the Christmas special? Horrible.
But when you consider what it set up...
Brilliant.
Oh,
that... Let's go.
Do they even have to talk? They could just touch tentacles and download.
Oh, this is so nice. Just three friends friending around.
Troy's been acting weird lately.
The same thing happened with my constable when he got a wife. Which means, of course, I now have one spare ticket to the 50th anniversary Inspector Spacetime convention in London.
Demisen Inspecticon? But it's so soon, and London's too far.
In England, Cadbury Cream Eggs are sold year-round.
I thought that was just a legend.
I can't wait. And we can visit the original Spacetime sets, and I've got a spare bedroom, so you can stay as long as you like.
Oh, that all sounds great. But I don't know if I can just pick up and leave. I have a life here.
For now.
What do you mean?
Well, let's face it, neurotypicals don't have the same focus you or I have. They always get distracted. My marriage, kids, competitive cooking shows.
David doesn't actually exist, does he?
You're mad. Nothing you've said can prove that.
Except that when we met, you said his name was Andrew.
Bollocks. When you sent me that first email in which you figured out that Inspector Spacetime is both his own grandfather and grandmother, I knew we were soulmates. You and I are special. Neurotypicals won't admit it, but some people are just better than everybody else.
But maybe there's a reason the Inspector always chooses a human companion. He's an alien, but his human friends keep him grounded and invested in the world, like with me and Troy. If I could winger you for a second?
Sure, I don't know what that means, but...
Maybe all relationships are made up of logical inspectors and emotional constables, and we need both to make space and time a better place. Wait, Toby, just a second. You have to let me out!
No, not until Stockholm Syndrome sets in.
How long do you think that'll be? A couple of hours? Would you love me if I got you a churro?
You know who Troy is! Yeah. Troy will find me.
You okay?
I am. You know, for the first time in my long history of being locked inside things, I knew someone would come. Still want to take the glow-on photo?
What do you think?
Yes.
Yes.
And I have a surprise for you guys.
Really pushing me here.
He's back.
There's only one way to find out.
I hate you. I just felt a strange disturbance.
Did you have dairy this morning?
Could be that. Or it could be that great evil's nearby. I'll take a provisional lactate. Dr. Blitz. Knight of the Atlantis Guild, wielder of the four-pronged trident and spawncraft.
How did you know?
I recognize your catchphrase. Tonight we dine in hell! I'm Spacetimer 8032.
You are Spacetimer 8032?
The one and only.
It's wonderful to meet you, brother.
I think we're the bad guys.
We are. When Carl and I were raiding the Diamond North Caves, I was facing 50 death beetles. I would have perished for sure, but he saved me. Then when I had a chance to return the favor, I looked him in the eye and I told him it was solid case. There's probably a way I can make it up to him. Maybe I'll give him my four-pronged trident.
Why don't you call it a quadrident?
Shh. I was gonna microwave buttered noodles, but this sounds equally promising. I'm in. Oh, I brought something.
Ooh.
Dip.
Oh, Abed, why is this seven-layer dip so puffy?
Oh, it's been in the fridge for 2 years.
I was saving it for a special occasion.
Oh, that's so thoughtful. I'm gonna put this on a nice platter with some crackers in the trash. Where's Britta?
It's a reference. That's my humor. Abed gets it.
Oh. Bennett Lockup was not where we belonged. We belonged in the sun, with the wind in our hair. Something about shackles on his heart? To be honest, I stopped listening. I was thinking about Christmas. I hope we do Die Hard. I hope it's in a restaurant. I hope it lays out as cleanly as it does in my dreams. I hope it's cool. Cool, cool, cool.
Cheers.
Doubtful. When he's alone, he mostly just practices smiling and frowning. We've all done it. Thanks. A lot of filmmakers use crane shots to elicit emotion. College dean threatening a fraternity. You'll never shut down the Delta Cubes.
What?
Delta Cubes. Delta Cubes. Placating students with a fun event. Classic bread and circuses. In ancient Rome, the emperor would distract the populace from their problems by allocating money for free bread and circuses. I've been making a conscious effort to get away from filtering everything through TV. I figured it's time I showed some growth. It's been 3.5 seasons, is what the old me would have said.
Oh. Where's this going?
Can I set you up with a date for the Sadie Hawkins Day dance?
A blind date. I've always thought of myself as more of an acquired taste, but... Okay.
Oh, if you're open to meeting someone, there's a number of eligible young ladies in my church.
Surely, I'm already finding a date for Abed. I asked first.
There's no reason we can't both help Abed find someone. Why don't we each pick a girl and then let Abed decide instead of making it a competition?
That's exactly a competition.
So it is.
Only for the loser.
Abed, this is Kat.
Hi, Kat. Nice to meet you.
She wants to ask you something. Isn't she perfect for Abed? She's like one of those quirky girls from the movies. I asked if you go to the Sadie Hawkins dance with me into the balloon. Could you hear it?
Sure, I'd be happy to go with you.
Super duper, Mr. Cooper.
At the risk of discovering I'm living two parallel lives like that guy in Awake, don't you already have a date to the dance?
Yep, now I have two, which means I can do the classic two dates in one night sitcom trope. I'll get to wear two outfits, mix up their names, maybe hide under a table.
But what about growth?
I tried to go in a more grounded direction, but I still ended up in a comically implausible situation. It's like Shirley said, it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for hijinks. Here, in lieu of flowers, I got you this. It's quirky.
Except you gotta lose the hat. It doesn't go with the minister's daughter.
You know what I'm doing?
Yeah, you're on two dates at once. I've been watching you since you came in.
I'm not good with faces. Is that a judgmental face or a happy face?
I think it's awesome.
So this thing's turning out to be a little tougher than I thought. You want help?
I'd like to, but I still got like 1,200 pages left of this Bible. Yes, of course I would.
Cool. Cool, cool, cool.
Oh, sorry. If this were a movie, this would be the part where we kiss.
You're right. Except we're doing a sitcom trope, so it would be totally out of place. Time to go get caught and make an impassioned plea to the girl I really like. I think I'm gonna go with Jessica. She seems to be the audience favorite. Okay, bye. Let me explain.
What about wanting to grow? Or was that just a lie so you could do another world-famous Abed TV adventure? These are real people you're messing with. Kat is over there hula-hooping all by herself.
Abed, in the real world, people can actually get hurt.
But the girl I liked all along wasn't under my nose. And now I screwed things up. I don't know if I can make them right.
Aww. Wait. This one's real, right?
Yeah, I'm really sad.
Aww. Well, go find her, dummy.
Yeah, haven't you ever seen a movie?
All right, Sophie. I have something to say. There was a girl here tonight. Her name was Rachel. I met her and it was very pleasant. And I made a mistake. And now I'd very much like to continue this conversation in private.
Yeah, and I don't need a puppet to express myself. I already say whatever I want.
Wait, Abed, you never told us your secret.
Oh, that's right.
I didn't share one that night. After we got back from the woods, everyone was being silent and not making eye contact. I didn't know why, so I mirrored your behavior.
Aww.
So this is Christmas. Just this. I was hoping we could do Die Hard in a restaurant. There's a place called Nakatomi Sushi. I hear the Hans Gruber is to die for. Come on, people. It's all spelled out in your Evites. I know you opened them. Oh, I brought gifts. Does Annie live here now?
I worked really hard.
Hey, Abed, got you an early Christmas gift. I know you were bummed about not doing Die Hard in a restaurant. And your recent divorce.
To Abed, yippee-ki-yay, Father Christmas.
I tried to get you taking off shoes, but I didn't know how to wrap it.
John McClane's tank top? You're getting really good at Christmas, Troy.
We'd all heard about your...
Well, how about you, the odd emotionalist Muslim? I mean, come on, you don't deserve an F. And you know that because of your impairment, they'll forgive you anyway.
All true, but I'm probably not your best target. If you don't mind, I'd like to get some popcorn. Typically, it takes a while for villains to ramp up. Promise not to monologue till I get back?
Give it.
I missed something great, didn't I?
Wait!
Oh my God. Jeff, do you have any milk duds?
Buttered noodles. My favorite.
Freaky Friday. Oh, Troy, you are so thoughtful. I wish I had the capacity for sentimentality like you do.
Me? I wish I was more like you. No emotional hang-ups, endless cool adventures. You have it so easy.
No, you do, Troy.
No, you do, Abed.
I wish I could switch places with you for just one day!
Shirley, did you ever date Roger Ebert?
Excuse me?
Nothing. Burnham, did you ever take pictures of your feet and post them on the internet for money?
No.
Guys, this history final. Abed, we don't have origin stories. We have lives. Abed, I know it's disappointing to you, but we're not superheroes. This is the real world, not some comic book adventure.
Noted.
Pierce Hawthorne, fixture at Greendale, unavoidable. Hey, is that a sad face?
I wouldn't know. This is good. This is really great. We're really filling in some plot holes here. It's good stuff. It's really good. Have I missed something?
There.
Because I had to go to school here. Abed, do not write that down.
I had to smile when I didn't feel like smiling.
If only I didn't have to pick up my kids at the mall, I could...
Wait. When? Which mall? Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Hey!
What movie are you guys gonna see?
The Phantom Menace. It's kind of old.
And why do you want to see it?
Because we like Star Wars.
Okay. If you like Star Wars, why do you want to murder it and urinate on its grave? The prequels are terrible. I mean, seriously, wouldn't Chewbacca at some point go, hey, Yoda, I know that guy.
He has double lightsabers.
That's stupid. You're both stupid.
This can't be.
I don't see why I have to go to a therapist.
Because after that woman chewed them out for 3 hours, the theater got a restraining order against you.
Hey, Doc. By the way, someone just stole your prescription pad. All this time, I wondered what it was that brought our group together. But I forgot one thing all heroes need. They need an enemy. And this study group has me. I'm the supervillain. Why didn't I see it before? I'm emotionless, logical, smarter than everybody else.
Hey!
I tried sawing off Jeff's arm.
Why do you keep saying that?
I should go. It's not safe to be around me. Just 10 minutes ago, I would have been so excited about that peeing thing. I wanted to make a prequel, and I ruined everything. I guess it could happen to anyone. I should probably write George Lucas a note of apology.
Okay, let's not get crazy. Walk over there right now and apologize to the theater manager.
Midichlorians. Midichlorians.
Fine. Then you're not going to film school.
That weird guy hasn't blinked once.
Oh, yeah. What a dweeb.
Yeah, what a dweeb. Oh, nice shot, man.
Everyone should have the same chance, don't you think? Chang?
That's not Chang. It's Kevin. How long have you known?
Known what? Only you know who you really are. Also, you may have experimental monkey fever.
We'll roll for it.
It didn't land on a number. That probably means nothing.
Hello, Abed.
Hello, evil Jeff.
What? How did you...
I may not be good with facial expressions, but I know an evil doppelganger when I see one. Plus, your arm makes a noise every time you move it.
Silence!
Is anyone here? Hello, Abed. Welcome to our home. Hello, evil Abed. It's just Abed now. After we met, I abandoned my evil goal to focus on brightening my own timeline instead. Do you live here alone?
Yes.
That's why he forced me to show him how to travel between timelines. My God. This is so cool.
I know.
Kind of a Superman 3 meets that Star Trek episode meets season 3 of The Cape. The Cape was canceled. Not here. They retooled it for cable, and it's awesome. Wanna see it?
Desperately. But I need to get back to my timeline and stop evil Jeff. So I came to the only person who could help me. Me.
I'll get you home, Abed. But first... You'll need some supplies.
Why don't I just give him what he wants?
What? You can't give up now.
Why not?
Because it's not real. Look around, Jeff. Haven't you noticed the vending machines are full of meats and hard-boiled eggs? So part of you wants evil Jeff to win, because then you could go backwards and pretend you're the same guy you were 4 years ago, but you're not. You're stronger. You're better. You have friends. No, screw that. You have a family.
Wait.
If this is all my mind, then I don't really need to fight him.
Don't logic this one away from me. We finally figured out a way to make paintball cool again.
You know, just to settle group arguments about who misses me the most.
Oh.